If you get a P2647 trouble code in a Honda Odyssey or actually any Honda vehicle, very often is the problem with the rocker arm oil pressure switch. So this switch is not really faulty, but at high mileage you can have the problem and you will need to replace this switch. But before you replace the switch, you may also try replacing the gasket for the switch, because the gasket is the thing that fails first, before the switch fails. And if the gasket fails, it will start leaking and it will start experiencing problems with oil pressure, and you will get this code. But before you do anything, before you invest in solving this problem, you should also make sure that everything is okay with the oil in your engine, because the oil pressure issues will trigger this code among other codes. And if there is low oil, the oil is old, the oil is too thick, you may actually get this error code. In some really rare cases, it can be the problem with the oil pump that doesn't create the proper pressure and the oil doesn't go into the upper part of your engine, into the head of your engine. And in this case, there will be other codes, but the P2647 will be one of them, and you can get it like the first code. But actually, in Honda cars, oil pumps are very reliable. It's like one case out of 100 that it can fail. This code may be thrown in cars with the VCM, or variable cylinder management, if I'm not mistaken, in large V6 engines. So this is the cylinder deactivation system that doesn't work properly, and there is no DIY solution for this VCM issue. You will need to find a good mechanic who can inspect older Honda engines and find a solution. If you're getting the VCM problem and this code, you will also get jerking of your engine, low power, bad acceleration, and all kinds of engine freaking out. Also, if you are replacing the rocker arm oil pressure switch, which is actually easy to replace, you need to buy the OEM switch, because aftermarket switches don't last long and they will make this problem come back pretty fast.